Just waiting for you guys. There we go. That's like the third time I've done that. Okay, yes, this Campman, I remember you. Isaac Einstein, love having you on the stream. Thanks for jumping on here. Also, you as well, Farming Golem. I can't forget you. You've been one of my favorite, or one of my early subscribers right from the beginning. So thank you so much for joining. And Jappy, yes, there we go. I got you. Okay, let me get my screen all set up, and then we can just jump in here. Oops. Okay, so far I'm 6-0 for a classic draft challenge. Super fun. Let's go ahead and let's do this. Boom, boom, ba dum, boom. Okay, a tip to this is picking your cards. I'm gonna go ahead and go with Hog Rider because he's a better win condition. We'll also go with the Mega Minion. I don't want him to have the cannon to counter my Hog Rider, so I'll go ahead and select the cannon. It's also a pretty good defense. And for some quick damage, we'll go with the regular stabby goblins. I don't have very much air defense, but that's okay. That happens. Thank you, okay. Good luck to you as well. Okay, he gave me the ice golem, or the ice wizard. Let's see what he... Okay, he's gonna go with a mortar right off the bat. We'll put the Mega Minion right there, try and get rid of that, and then we'll go for another push right here with the fire spirits. That wizard and my ice wizard are gonna have a fun time with each other. He's gonna end up zapping that, and those spear goblins are not gonna take out my hog rider as fast as my stabby goblins would have, so I'm glad that I did this. Okay, now he did give me the royal giant. I wish that I had my ice wizard in the other way around, so I could put that down first, but we'll place the royal giant right there. And we'll place the goblins as well as the mega minion. Now he placed the P.E.K.K.A. in the very far back, which is not ideal. In fact, the P.E.K.K.A., placing it at the front where the Royal Giant in this situation is actually something that I would highly recommend doing. I wouldn't always recommend people doing that, but definitely in this situation. We'll go ahead and cannon, fire spirit, or ice wizard. Try and get that. Oh no! Oh shoot. Okay. Oh man, there we go. Had to try and push him out of the range there so we could get rid of him. The mortar. Oops, placed that just in the wrong spot. It's okay, we got the Mega Minion right here. It's gonna end up doing some damage on the tower that I don't want to have happen. We'll cycle back to our Hog Rider. And by placing down those Fire Spirits right there. He's gonna have to really worry about the other lane. I don't know if he's gonna place down the P.E.K.K.A. He is. Okay. You know what? Oh man, this is annoying. This is very annoying. I should have put that down the other lane. That's okay. We'll put the cannon right here. And the Hog Rider right there. I'm gonna poison all of that. And Where are... Ooh. There we go. Good defense. He does have the fireball, so I have to be careful. We'll go and place these fire spirits right there. Get rid of those. We'll try and add a little bit of extra damage onto the tower. Probably was a little too soon for me to actually use the poison. Poison's a little in a tough spot right now. He's ready to fireball that. Here's what we'll do. In fact, I probably could have placed... Come on. There we go. And with the Ice Wizard, that's gonna be a tower. Good game, well played, sir. That was very good. Okay. Thanks, Farming Golem. Yeah, Farming Golem, if you do, so how my donation perks are set up, I've got $2 for Rate My Deck, or anything over $2 will actually be announced on the stream. And so then there's $5 where you give me a deck and I'll rate it, play around with it, try messing with it, making it a little bit better, give you some suggestions on how to play it, and also make improvements to it. And then $10, I will make you a deck. You tell me, hey, Kairos, I want a good Sparky deck. Okay, $10, I will do everything that I can to try and make you a good Sparky deck. Now, that being said, I'm not always going to be able to do that on the stream because Sparky's a really difficult card to make a solid deck for. And so it takes some good time for me to do that. I'm not able to do on the stream, now sometimes I will be able to make a good, I'd say the majority of the time I'll be able to make a good deck on the stream. But if I don't feel like I gave your deck what it really deserved, you know, that $10 worth, then I'll do some testing after the stream, mess around with some things, and then I'll actually send you an email with the deck and explain you how to do it. So, kind of cool. Something a little bit different that I don't think other streamers are doing. So check the link in the description below, Farming Golem. There's a link there that you can actually get to my Twitch, to the donations section right there. But anyways, let's go ahead and jump into the battle. Do another one. I think that I'm gonna select the, I don't know what the other cards are, so I'm gonna go with him. I'll also go with the princess because I like her a little bit more. And then Expo is a deck that I really love Expo. Ooh, you know what? I'm gonna go with the Hog Rider. The Golem Barrel is a good card, but with my princess and my bomber, I think that I might be fine. I don't know what spell. He's probably gonna end up giving me a spell of some sort. I don't know what he's gonna give me. Okay, looks like we have the guard and the royal, or the dark giant, or the dark prince. Okay, well, we'll get some damage onto the tower at least. We'll try and finish off that Mega Minion with the princess. Oh, in fact, that was not a good placement. I should have put her just a little bit further to the left. Ooh, it's actually gonna work out though. Yeah, so let's wait 1 second. Nope. We'll put this bomber right there. Equal elixir trade. I think that's pretty good. And here we're gonna pull the Mega Minion. And then maybe get it to hit on the tower with that one stabby goblin. Oh, nope, not quite. Okay, now I'm ready back with my Expo. He probably has his Tesla, so I'm probably not going to actually do that. What I'm going to do is, I'm going to place the Hog Rider right there, and I'm going to place this Expo super defensively. We'll put the princess, ooh, meant to put her on the other side. Not great. Come on. And that log's going to reach her? Not going to reach her. That was tough. That was very tough. We'll put this bomber right here, and then we'll get back to the goblins. And Hog Rider's away. Right, ready for that Tesla. I thought that was going to be an issue. But you know what? That bomber actually worked out really well. We're going to get some damage onto the tower, maybe even take it out. Yep, there we go. That's a tower. Excellent. And we're ready with our Expo again. In fact, what I'll probably end up doing... You know what? No. I'm going to place the Expo right there. The princess right here. I'm ready for his Mega Minion. He didn't place down the Mega Minion, actually. That was not great. That was not great. It wasn't awful. Was not great. Okay. Well, he spent a ton of elixir to try and defend against that. Ah, shoot. We'll go for a tower. That's what we'll do. He took me off guard. That was a really good moment for him to go for that. The hardest thing is this Dark Prince. I don't know exactly what to do with him. Well, we'll build up a push. That's what we'll do. Yeah, that's what we'll do. Okay, place the guards just a little. Well, actually, that worked out. Now we've got all. Where's his goblin barrel? I thought for sure. There we go. Come on. Sorry, concentration mode right here. Come on, Hog Rider. Hog Rider away. One hit. Ooh. Nope, that's not gonna splash. Not gonna splash. We'll put the princess over here, out of the log's way, which is good. And it's also gonna get some damage on there. Ah, that was a good placement of his spear goblins. Let's put this hog rider right here. We'll put the bomber right here. Do a little bit more damage right onto that Tesla, which we knew that he was gonna be placing down. If that hog rider can get one hit, no, not quite. Thought that was gonna be finishing it off. What I would like to do then, I would like to put the princess right there. No, come on. Bomber. Dang it, super close. Woo! Okay, that was intense. Okay, clan name. Let's see here. I'm in the Kairos Warriors. We have quite a few clans. We got three clans: Kairos Warriors, Kairos Knights, Kairos Clashers. Tons of fun. Am I over 2400? Yes, I'm very much over 2400. I usually at the end of the season I'm about 4300 actually trophies. And let's see here, Kairos. If you want to make a deck for me, do I need to post a deck or the main cards you want in it? Just the main cards that you want in it, Barlupo. If you want me to make a deck and you do that $10 donation, just tell me like any specifications. You could just say make me a deck, and I could go with whatever. You could also say make me a P.E.K.K.A. deck, and I'll definitely give that some good thought there. Dark Prince Hog, yeah, I could have done that. The Dark Prince is just weird. Hey Exordium, great to have you jump on here. Gaming with Mo. Let's see here. Yeah, I guess that's true as far as him not being able to place a swarm, especially because he was using those spear goblins to try and defend against it. Cedra, thanks for jumping on here. Really appreciate it. Magic Shoe, also great to have you. But hey, first loss at 7 wins. I think that's pretty good. Ooh, okay, I'm gonna go with the Three Musketeers. Lady Kairos and the baby are doing excellent. Baby Kairos is having a great time. She's napping right now. We'll go ahead and go with a Royal Giant. I hate the bowler. I hate facing against the bowler. I don't hate the bowler. I just don't like facing against it, so I'm going to select it. Let's hope he gave me some cheap cards. Because if he did not, then I put myself into a world of hurt right there. Okay, Frosty YouTube. Hey, Frosty! I don't know if this is the Frosty that's been following me on YouTube, but if it is... good luck, man. We'll put the bowler right here. Yeah, Dark Prince is a hard... Baby Kairos is a girl. Dark Prince is very, very hard to try and figure it out. I might actually place the minions. And let's do this. He's going to try raging that. I don't blame him, actually. Oh, I thought that I had placed that down a little sooner. Okay, well, that didn't work out. Okay, if he doesn't have something to get rid of that Electro Wizard, then that's good. Oh, nope, that wizard's gonna do very good, actually. We'll probably go with the bowler. I don't want the wizard's attack to attack both the bowler and my tower, so I'm gonna place it right there. Now send me free. Thanks, Farming Golem. I don't know if I'd say or be full of myself and say she's super lucky, but I like being her dad. She's a lot of fun. I really like her a lot. Okay, so he's got the Rage Lumberjack combination. Okay. Let's see here. That's going to do quite a bit of damage onto the Musketeer, but it's not going to finish her off. She'll probably still get one shot off. And so what I'll do is right here, I'll put down the Royal Giant. Oh, and I pushed her right into the wrong spot. That's okay. Let's place the Witch. That Wizard does a good job against my Royal Giant. Absolutely, it does. I mean, not before I'm going to get some damage onto the tower, but... here's what we'll do. We're probably going to lose a tower because of this. Yeah. I think my best move at this point is probably a Three Musketeer split. Come on. Bowler to the rescue. Ah, man, see? I made too much of a heavy deck is really what it came down to. Royal Giants away! Come on, Royal Giant. One shot. Ah, so close. So close. Hey, well, good game, Frosty YouTube. You did well. And so far, we're 2-0. Or not 2-0. We're 7-2. Okay. Yeah, Dark Prince really only works out super well if you build a deck around it, which is... I mean, and who wants to build a deck around the Dark Prince? Thanks, Jay. Jamie Broadcast, thanks to have you here. Lackluster Community, make sure you guys check out Lackluster Gaming YouTube. He's pretty fantastic. Really great guy. I'm going to go with the Electro Wizard here. And I'm going to use the Fireball because the Electro Wizard is very easily countered against the Fireball at the moment. You know, I think that the Tombstone might be a little bit more annoying against the Mortar. And we'll go ahead and go with the Balloon. Hey, the Shadow, thanks for jumping on. Potato, great to have you on here as well. Okay, this will be a fun little push. I don't know if this would ever work in a normal ladder challenge, but we'll try it now. 1, 2, 3 smacks on there. He tried to pull the balloon, but it didn't quite make it. And let's get rid of all of that, because that is a very positive elixir trade. And we're already starting out with the tower. Excellent. We'll put the Mega Minion right here to try and finish off those barbarians. They might get just a little bit of damage onto the tower, but... okay, more than I would like, actually. Okay, they did way more damage than I would have liked. I could have defended against them, but you guys know how it goes. Here's what we'll do. I'm going to place the Mini P.E.K.K.A. right here, super random. And we'll put the Lumberjack right there. And we got those two hard hitters going onto the tower. He just doesn't have anything that can really defend against this. And so we'll put the Tombstone right here to pull the Hog Rider all the way over there. And my Mini P.E.K.K.A. Lumberjack combo, we're going crazy onto the tower. With the Rage on there, and that's a tower. 3 crown right off the bat. That was great. Oh, man. Good game. Well played, sir. That was super fun. Yeah, I'm definitely going to be collaborating with Lackluster again. Thoughts on the balance update? Hey, good question there, Eric Bauhaus. I'm really excited about this update. The Zap has been one of the most used cards. I know, right? The funny thing is about that last match is that the funny thing about that last match is that I just decided to go for a really random push at the beginning, and it worked because it's totally caught him off guard. A normal deck probably would have been able to defend against that pretty easily, but that was just tower after tower after tower. But yeah, Zap has been super strong ever since it got its very first buff. Way back forever ago when the game was very brand new. I think it was in February. And I'm excited for the Zap. I mean, I love Zap. I love Zap. It's one of my favorite cards. I've had it in almost every single deck, either the Zap or the Log, for months. the majority of the past year. And I think that that's the biggest problem. People don't use arrows very much, and I don't blame them, because arrows are, I mean, they're not super strong right now, unless you have like a golem or a lava hound deck. And so, anyways. Okay, let's go ahead and jump back into there. On Zap 8 decks, I'll get back to that. I want to focus just for a second. We'll play a little bit more defensively. Also, defensively, I'm going to take Zap over the Skeletons, of course. Interesting. We'll go ahead and go with the... I think that I'm going to take the Mini Peck. No, you know what? I'm going to take the Lumberjack. Lumberjack's a little bit better against the Witch, so I'm going to do that. Yeah, I'll get back to you, Trainer Yorgi. I'm trying to do a better job at focusing on the actual... Now, he gave me Lightning Bomb Tower. Super interesting. Yeah, I'm trying to do a better job at actually focusing on the gameplay while I'm doing it. And then I'll get right back to your guys' comments as soon as this match is done. We'll put the Lumberjack... Ah, dang it. Okay, well... He was already locked onto the princess. I don't know what kind of a push he's going to go for. But we'll put the Inferno Dragon right here. He's going to go with the Witch. And he also does have the Wizard. So I'm not going to... Here's what I'll do. Hey, Farming Golem. Thanks for following on Twitch. Really appreciate the support. And Nicole Coates. Thanks for jumping on YouTube. Really appreciate that. Is that going to take out the Wizard all the way? No, it's not going to take it out all the way. But we'll put this Goblin Hunt right here. And the Princess in the far back. Try to help get rid of that Miner. And... I was hoping that wouldn't take that out. Oh, well, that's still one less Elixir, so it's not that awful. He's going to end up logging. And here's what we're going to do. This is super risky, but he doesn't have Zap. He's going to get rid of those three. He doesn't have Zap. He's going to distract with that Mini P.E.K.K.A. Is... Come on. There we go. Demon Van Sos, thanks for jumping on YouTube. Really appreciate the support. Well, that super risky, weird move did not work out. Not surprised. It would have been cool if it would have worked out. But it didn't. Maybe I should go for some chip on the other side. He recently logged. This will give him a positive elixir if he does log. Okay, here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to split this minion horde. Some of them are going to go take care of the Valkyrie, and some of them are going to go take, care of the bowler. Okay, that's within range of both the wizard and the bowler, which is excellent. Get rid of them. He just barely logged, so I'm going to go for some chip damage right here. Come on, get rid of the Valkyrie. Nope. We're going to do the same thing that we did. And... Nope, that was too far out of range. Dang it. Hey, you know what? That's actually going to work out really, really well, though. Yeah, it's a spam hut. Well, if he's going to do that, we'll put this right here. He's going to log that, which I don't blame him for doing that. Not at all. We'll put the Inferno Dragon right there. We're going to do the Lumberjack kind of as another little bit more of a pressure, I guess. I just have a really weird deck. That makes it tough. No, that could be the tower. Yep, that's the tower. Good game, well played. Man, do you guys have any suggestions on how I could have done that? That was just weird. I gave him his miner too much time on each of those towers. I just didn't think he was going to come down to that, but hey, that's okay. You win some, you lose some. Okay, let's check this out. Okay, so do I think that Zap Nerf is going to cause an issue for like Zap Bait decks? Well, the big Zap Bait decks you're going to have... I should have Lightning, you're right. Especially when he has that witch coming down here. I'm so afraid, well, not afraid to use the Lightning. I'm not used to using the Lightning, really, when it comes down to play Inferno Dragon instead of Lightning. Good call there, Tabaro. Good call. Okay, let's see here. So, use Inferno Dragon on defense instead of like splitting my minion horde. Yeah, definitely doing some weird stuff. Okay, well, hey, we got 8 wins, which is pretty good. I mean, it's not the best, but let's go ahead and do a grand challenge. 3 huts on the field is frustrating for your opponent. Absolutely, I could have gone for the other way. Let's see. Yeah, you can get into the clan if you're not 18 years of age farming Golem, but we are looking for a maturity level of 18. End of gaming, hey, thanks for jumping on here. Thanks for the suggestion there, Domin Van So, saying I'm good at Clash Royale. Okay, let's jump in here. Okay, I'm going to go ahead and go with the 3 Musketeers. That's a little bit pricey. And I'm going to take the Lightning, of course, because I don't want him to have that for my 3 Musketeers. And he has the arrows, but I don't want to not have a counter to his princess, so I'm going to go ahead and take the princess, and we'll go with, you know what, we'll go arrow bait. Whether or not I'm going to be able to defend against his hog is going to be dependent on what he gives me, which is not the greatest. Oh, man. Okay, 3 Musketeers. Let's get rid of that Hog Rider. Come on. Gonna get a little bit of damage onto the tower. We'll go ahead and Goblin Barrel that. And he decided to arrow that. Very good. We'll get rid of those Lava Puffs using the Archers, and the Archers should also make quick work of the Guards as well. Which will be excellent. Now, we'll get some chip damage right here. I don't think that the arrows are cycled back into his hand. Remember, I'm playing arrow bait. That's what I'm doing here. And then if I can put this graveyard right here, that would be excellent. Let's see what he decides to do. He spent 4 elixir to try and get rid of this witch. He's going to use the Zap Wizard. Electro Wizard. Zap. And my graveyard's going to take care of the Electro Wizard. The mortar's going to help, but not before getting a ton of damage on there. And, well, we'll do this then. Get rid of the Hog Rider with my Dark Prince. But hey, we got our Goblin Barrel ready to go. And Archers. Help out with that Mega Minion. Come on. And he's going to land a hit on the tower. Is he going to take it out? That actually worked. Oh, fantastic. We'll put the princess nowhere. We're just gonna build up our elixir. We'll actually probably go for the 3 Musketeers. Now, we cannot cycle, or we cannot split our 3 Musketeers because we have a tower down. Ooh, okay. Never mind. Don't want to do that. Just trying to think. Oh, no. Musketeers are going down the other lane from where that Inferno, or the, not Inferno Dragon, Lava Hound is. We'll put the Princess right here to help take care of it. Put the Dark Prince once again. And then the Archers in the back. Maybe they'll be able to get rid of the Hog Rider. Not quite in time. Okay, that's going to be a tower on his side of things. Especially if he arrows. Oh, he missed the Princess. But he did use his arrow, and that's excellent. So here's what we'll do. Get rid of the mortar, put some pressure, Goblin Barrel right there. He's going to use the Electro Wizard. And he's not going to be able to get rid of those Goblin Barrels unless he uses that. Oh, Dark Prince again. Come on, get rid of him. I wish that I had some type of like anti-air. And we'll do this. He's gonna arrow that. Maybe we can get double arrows onto his tower because the princesses. Okay, let's see here. And graveyard. Not quite. We'll get ready for the graveyard. And then we can lightning finish off the tower. Oh, man. Yep. Do it like that. Goblin barrel. I don't know if he's going to use the arrows. There we go. He's placing the mortar actually very well defensively. What we'll do is we'll place this Dark Prince right here and then graveyard that. Save up for the lightning. Gonna reset both those towers, and that is super close to game. Archer's right here. I'm worried about the Hog Rider. Okay, well, you can do that then. Come on, Dark Prince. And that's game. Closer than I would have liked it. Absolutely closer than I would have liked it. But hey, there we go. No! Smart move! Oh my gosh, I love that. I love that so much. I love it when people pull off cool stuff like that. I really do. Ah. Cool. I cannot believe that. Okay. I made like the biggest noob mistake. Well, I guess it's not a big noob mistake. You guys get the idea. Okay. Yeah, archers. Wish archers didn't get a nerf though. Yeah, archers are... Yeah, I have a little... Not much to say about that, actually. I feel like they're not too bad. Yeah, I could have put the three musketeers on his side. Absolutely. He kept putting the mortar there, which was really annoying. It worked out once. I should have done it again. Will I bring back challenge winning decks? Absolutely. Jamie Broadcast, I do have plans to do it. Not as many people have been jumping onto my Kairos Studios clan, and because they haven't been doing that as much, I haven't been able to do a whole bunch of challenge winning decks. But now that I am... Yeah, that lightning. Don't even say it, Rubea. Ahmad. Oh, man. He just postponed it. Yeah, super fun. I forgot what I was saying. I need to do a better job remembering what I'm saying. Oh, challenge winning decks. Yeah, so once people start putting more into my Kairos Studios clans, then what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to make it a stream where I take a bunch of challenge winning decks that people have put into my Kairos Studios. We're going to talk about them. We're going to play them. I'm going to try learning them for the first time. It's going to be a ton of fun. Hog Rider, will it be better after the balance changes? I think so, but not just because of the Hog Rider. I think it's going to be better because you can pair it up with the Stabby Goblins, and the Stabby Goblins aren't going to be taken out as easily by Zap. Should be a ton of fun. Yep. Duo Gaming YouTube. You can apply to the Kairos Kingdom clans. Just check it out in the description below. Let's jump into another one. Hey, Trainer Yori. Thanks for jumping on. Really appreciate it. Gonna go with the Tesla. Super hard to fix that. You know what? Fireball's a good counter to the Tesla if they play it right, but most people don't know how to do it, so I'm gonna choose Zap. I mean, it's not hard to do, it's just most people don't do it right. We'll go ahead and go with the Hog Rider. They'll focus their Fireball for something else. Ooh, should we go super defensive? No, we'll take the Tombstone, because the Tombstone's such a good counter against the Hog Rider. We'll do that. Okay, Tubo, you do that. I'm gonna see what he has to face to stop the Hog Rider. We'll place that right there. I think that I barely put my Expo out of range. Nope. Cool. Well, now we're defensive, so that's good. Hey, faithful to him. You've been enjoying Star Wars Force Arena? Super fun, right? If you guys have tried the game out, make sure you let me know if you think that I should stream it more. I did for the first time today. It was a lot of fun. I like it. Like the game. I'm total noob at it, but... He's gonna fireball that. Ooh, you know what? We'll get rid of that Dark Goblin. Come on, lock on the Dark Goblin. Very good. And he's got quite a bit of a defense going up right there, or counterattack. But, I mean, now he does have Fireball. If he did not have Fireball, then I wouldn't do this. But I don't want him to Fireball everything, because that's too much of a positive elixir trade, right? Let's see, he has the Goblin, or the Guards. We'll just leave those be. Ice Wizard. Now, if I can get up enough elixir to put down that Expo, then that'd be awesome. And, yep, I think that we'll be good. Put the Expo down. If he places Golem right in the front, that'll suck, but he's not going to do that. Okay, I'll give that to you. Ah, placed that just in the... Didn't do that very well. Okay, Zapter. I didn't want to get too much damage onto the tower. He does have Tesla Tower. Tesla is a little bit trickier to... Ah, come on. To avoid with the hog push, or it's a little bit harder to place it, right? Dang it, did not pull the Golem. Okay, well, that'll be good then. And he's gonna Fireball all of that, don't blame him. That was a very good Fireball. Come on! And that's a Fireball's worth. Let's hope we at least freak him out. Maybe we'll freak him out and then he won't Fireball the tower. good game, sir. Well played. So, when it came down to it, when he placed down that Golem, I should have rushed the other lane. That's really what I should have done. I think that that's why I lost that, because then he had the Fireball all built up. He was able to build up a push with that Golem because I rushed that same lane. It's tough. It's tough. I was hoping to try and get the tower, but that was my fault. That's okay. Let's see. Hey, Marcella Alma. Thanks for jumping on here. Who's in Arena 10? I'm in Arena 10. If you're in Arena 6, that's okay. We love having you here. We'll get you there. Just keep watching. You'll get better at the game just by watching. And practice. Practice and watch. You know what? I'm going to go ahead and go with the rock. No. I'll go with the expo. I just love the expo. And we'll go with the log. This could be a good deck, actually. Huh. Well. He doesn't have any good counters to the Hog Rider. From what I gave him, he might, but... So I selected the Hog Rider right there instead. And hey, Rias Estrada, thanks for subbing on YouTube. Really appreciate that. We got Princess in the back, and he's gonna place the Wizard over there. So what I'm going to do is I'm gonna place down this Expo, and I'm going to place this Ice Spirit. There we go. He's gonna rocket my Expo for a neutral elixir trade. And we'll go with the Mini P.E.K.K.A. right there. Just put him into a little bit of a tough situation. Which he responded to very well. But not before we got some damage onto the tower. And that knight is ready to go down. Rebea Ahmad, thanks for subbing on YouTube. Great to have you as a part of the Kairos family. Ba-da-dum. We're going to put the Musketeer right here. Let that build up. I'm waiting for his mortar. Wow, okay. Well then, we'll put the Expo in the most annoying place for him. Marcella Alma. Really though, thanks for jumping on YouTube. It really does make a... Really does... Well, it's fun. I really like it. Oh, did not do that push right. That's okay. The Expo ended up working out very well. It's gonna freeze that Prince. The Dark Prince. My Hog Rider's gonna get some more hits on there. Tesla Tower is going to help take out the mortar. Very good. There. Last time he defended against the Mini P.E.K.K.A. with his knight. He's going to do it with the wizard this time. Bum, 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 bum. Put the Ice Wizard right there. And that's going to do more damage than I would like. Here's what we'll do. He's going to lightning right there. We're going to do a peg push down the lane. They're both going to go down towards the tower. Come on, Mini Pekka, get rid of the furnace. You got this. I want to save that princess. He's going to end up rocketing the expo once again. And we're ready for another hog push. Come on. This could be the tower. Nope. Not quite. Bup, 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 hi. Oh man, that was so good. I don't know why I didn't think about that. Okay. Gotta get rid of this. He's gonna get one shell down. If I can just take it out before the second one, though, that's good. But he has the lightning and the rocket. Wow, good game. Well played, Andrew. Man. Thunder Lotus Gaming, I miss you? What happened, man? It should have popped up. Yeah, resubbing over and over again doesn't work out. Unsubbing, resubbing, that doesn't work out. But hey, Thunder Lotus Gaming, thanks for jumping on. Appreciate it. How did I miss it? Did the noise not come up? Eh, well, hey. Luchik Royale, thanks for jumping on. Great to have you participating in the chat. Really love seeing that. Okay, not doing too well. Come on, Kairos. You're live streaming. Pay more attention. Reyes Estrada. Okay, what do I think about the new balances updates? Oh, and Soccer 7, great to have you here as well. I'm really excited about it. I mentioned a little bit earlier that I'm excited that the zap is hopefully not going to become... Well, it's not going to be totally overpowered. I was in focus mode. Okay. I do. I'm trying to do a better job at playing really well when I'm streaming. Because I've been trying really to focus on the people. And I love talking to the people. Absolutely love it. But I don't want to be losing all the time. You know what I mean? Wow. I love the giant skeleton. I think that I'm going to go with the golem here because I do have that elixir collector. Let's see here. Electro Wizard OP. I don't know if it'll be overpowered, but it'll definitely be a lot stronger than it is right now, especially because it can't just be fireballed. Okay, that worked out. That was a really fast push on his part. Do I like cheesecake? Oh man, I love cheesecake. Cheesecake's delicious. Seriously, cheesecake? Me and Cheesecake go way back. Okay, I have the super heavy deck right here. I've got to try and get this pump up. He does have the miner, so I'm ready with the Valkyrie. Or, you know, that as well. That worked out excellently, actually. He's going to zap it, and then we've got an Elite Barbarian Valkyrie push. I'm excited about this push we got building up here. Right now. And there they are. Thought that was gonna happen. Oh man, they just didn't die quite fast enough. Hey, Clash Royale stick. Attic, sorry. Ah, more damage than I would've liked. If I can pump up, okay, yeah, you place your miner right where I want him to be placed, and then we've got our pumps. I might even try to go for some type of a three crown. No, I'm not. We'll go with the lava, well, I don't know, we'll put this lava hound right here, and he's gonna place the giant skeleton. Come on. Hey, Lost Fate. Appreciate the support. Really do. That worked out much better than it possibly could have. No. Wow. Oh, that was great timing. Come on. Nope. Thought that might have worked out. No. Had the tower and lost it. Failure. Hey there, Fabijan Foo. Sorry. I'd probably better not even try that one. Then I have this princess to worry about. That was a good placement. Oh my gosh, that was so good. I love it when people do stuff like that. Come on. That's gonna be the tower, guys. Oh my gosh, come on. There we go. So close. No, yes. I don't even like have a spell. Come on, where's his miner? He's got a... Come on. One hit, that's all I need. There we go. That was way close. I can't even believe that. That was crazy. Wow as well. Good game. Well played. That came way closer than I was expected. Ah, man. Okay, lots of stuff going on here. What clan am I in? Hey, Nicole Coates. Thanks for jumping on here. Rishav Sharma, thanks for subbing, man. Really appreciate it. Okay, guys, let's see here. Lost Fate, Legendary Duos, I think is going to be better. Electro Wizard, Ice Wizard. After the update, probably Electro Wizard. Right now, probably Ice Wizard. Do I like pizza? Raya's Estrada, come on, man. Everybody loves pizza. I love pizza. Really do. Let's see here. Who's a clan? Required 1,700 trophies. Marcella, once you're past 2,000 trophies, you can apply to the Kairos Kingdom. There's more information below. Ooh. Very intense. Yeah, losing streaks happen there, Driptide. I know how you feel about it. Hey, RV Gaming, I haven't ever checked your channel out, so how about this? You find me on Twitter. Send me a message there, and we can talk about it. And then John Alaba, there's an application in the link below to join our clans. We're very selective about the people that we're looking for. We're looking for people that are positive, mature, active, who donate, and are also able to be active in chat and Discord, which is the chat that we use. If you don't have Twitter, you can find me on Facebook. There's a link to my my Facebook account in the description below. You can friend me, and then we can private chat there. But yeah, that was close. We'll just do a couple more matches. And I'll probably be done for the day. Super fun. That was great. Let's do this. You know, I keep on picking the Expo, and it's not working out. So I'm going to go ahead with the Mega Minion. And we'll go with the Minion Horde. And the baby dragon. Let's go with the Tesla Tower to try and take out that Lava Hound. This will be weird. I love how weird these matches can get. Hey, if you're gonna be angry at me right off the bat, we'll put the Valkyrie right here. And the Mega Minion right there as well. Oh man. Yes. Yes, please. I don't know what kind of push this is. I don't have a win condition. There's no wind condition in my deck. Okay, so he's got the Lava Hound, which is the only wind condition in my, or that I've seen. And the Expo. That was so good. Love how he did that. Hey, Boss Branson. Okay, if he's gonna place that, then we'll place the Fire Spirits just a little bit out of range. Oh, one of them is gonna get taken out, actually. Okay, so I spent 4 Elixir to take out 3 Elixir. And he's gonna spend way more Elixir to defend. We'll do the minion horde. Get rid of everything. Come on. That's gonna get one hit on there. Oh, and then that wizard. That wizard. You're a wizard, Ice Wizard. Who loves Harry Potter? Lady Kairos and I are actually in a Harry Potter marathon right now. Watching all the Harry Potters. We do that every year, actually. I don't have a great counter to a lot of his cards, which is... yeah. Where's my music? No! I switched my music. I knew I was going to lose the tower, but... Okay, let's do this. Okay, well, we got the tower. I'm gonna place the baby dragon right here. The Tesla tower right there. Valkyrie right next to that expo. And successful defense for an awkward push of his. Ah, that was not good. Not good. Why did I do that? Get rid of everything. Just get rid of it all. Oh, man. We'll go for another weird push. It's so weird when you end up facing somebody and you don't have a win condition. It's like, what do? You just hope for the minion horde, right? Hope that your minion horde can land on the tower. I mean, we're doing a weird battle right in the middle of the... I mean, right in the middle of it all. It's just weird. It's just weird. It's really what it comes down to. And he has the trifecta, the Lava Hound trifecta. Get rid of those guards. Okay. Time to go. Let's do this. Dang it. Not good. I mean, if I had any win condition. I mean, I can't blame this on the fact that I don't have a win condition, but you guys get the idea. I'm losing because I'm losing. The win condition does help. He has Zap, and the game is over. And my Valkyrie went the other way. Dang it. Dude, all you have to do is put down Zap. That's all you have to do, and you've won. That's all he has to do. There we go. Good game. Well played. Oh, man. Weird. Okay, let's see here. One up. What do I do for work? I am a supervisor in a call center, actually. I've got a team of that ranges anywhere between 12 and 22 people. I don't clash for work. Clash is a lot of fun, though. Okay, cool. Thanks, RG. I'll make sure and friend you on Facebook. I don't have any time for any more matches, and it's really unfortunate that I went for two losses. But hey, two wins is enough to actually make 100 gems actually worth it, because you get 2,500 gold, lots of rares and or commons, and then you got quite a few rares actually, so that's pretty good. Thunder Lotus Gaming, if you're interested in joining my clan, make sure that you check the application link below. You fill out an application and we'll see you. Fahim Gurji? I know I said that wrong, I'm sorry. But thanks for jumping on the stream, really do appreciate it. Let's see here, sorry to get off subject, but can I join my guild on Star Wars Force Arena? Absolutely faithful to him. I don't know where I'm going to be going on Star Wars Faith or Star Wars Force Arena, but I'd love to have you there. It's Kairos Warriors. Just apply there and I'll check it out. Hey, thanks Sunbee. Gwen Sunbee. Really appreciate you jumping on here. And let's see here. Reyes Estrada. Thanks, man. I appreciate you thinking I'm your favorite YouTuber. Really does mean a lot. I really love getting on here and doing some stuff. Should play We Will Rock You. I'm worried about copyright issues. Cool. Okay, for those of you who are new to my channel, I stream every Monday, Tuesday, and Thursday at 1 p.m. Mountain Time, or Kairos Time is what I say. See ya, Pratesh. Make sure you jump on. Those are my minimum streaming days. So I'm likely to stream on other days, like today. It's today, Saturday. It's not my actual stream schedule, but I want to jump on. I was like, hey, I got some time. Want to have some fun. And make sure you subscribe if you haven't already. Really appreciate your support. No, I'm not going to be streaming again tonight. I've got a date with Lady Kairos. We're going to have some fun. Going to go play some games with some friends of ours. So it'll be excellent. For now, this is Kairos Time ticking by, and we will see you in the arena on Monday, Tuesday, and Thursday at 1 p.m. Kairos Time.